Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot, and we are back playing Minecraft Dinosaurs. A Minecraft which the entire population has seemingly... Hello, buddy. Has seemingly started to play in the next, couple of weeks. I'm a trendsetter, as I always knew I was. Right, so a few things have changed since the last video. I've put signs up for my boxes. There's a piglet. There he is, looking adorable. We have a name tag. I also have the pteranodon eggs ready to go, and some wood and some dirt, all of which will become useful very soon. I also have lots of stone, as you'll see, for pretty good reason. So, first things first, we're going to name ourselves... is this how you do it? Permo, that was the name. Permo. Boop. As a name suggested by you guys at home for the Ankylosaurus, because we have Tempo for temporary, because that's a temporary name, and Permo for the permanent name for the Ankylosaurus. So let's go name our Anky. Where have you gone, buddy? Look at that pig. I want to name the piggy. I want a way to freeze the piggies so they stay as piglets forever, you know? Is that so much to ask for? There you go, buddy. Permo. Permo and Tempo. In the next video, we will name our pteranodons as well, which we're going to hatch today. Now, this has taken quite a lot of work. I did record a big time lapse of what we're about to see, but it is exceptionally boring. So I'm unsure whether we're actually going to include it. We're going to have a little think about that. Let's fill this in whilst we're here. I do have block breaking off again, but yeah, that's after my entire world kind of got destroyed. So let's fix that. We do need the dirt. Don't need the bucket. Let's put that away, and then I will show you what I have been working on. I've been a busy little bee. Bucket no longer goes in here. Bucket now goes in here. Right, yes. Right, so, also, hammer. I was looking at this. I was going to try to make one of these ones for the Tinker's Constructs, because that was recommended from you guys at home. I have no idea how Tinkers work. I'm going to do some research in the next video. We're going to do some Tinker's stuff, I think. We're going to have a chill one, because today is going to be a little bit intense. Right, so as you can see, I have a new teleport. Boop! And it's Pterosaur Mountain, and here it is. I've got a bed, because I would die otherwise. And if we just jump off this little diving board a bit, you can jump off and not die, but it made me a little bit nervous. I did do this by hand. I sat here for about 30 minutes, I would say, with 7 pickaxes or something and knocked it out. But this is Pterosaur Mountain. Now, the plan, and this was suggested by one of you guys at home, and I still don't really know what the plan is, if I'm honest, is to have like a wooden platform that comes out around the base of that gap, and then that platform's going to have like a dome that goes up into the mountain, and that's where the pterosaurs will be able to fly. I'm also thinking we hollow out like a chamber in the middle of the mountain, and then they can fly up there as well. It does feel like slightly limited space, but we are playing on survival mode. It's quite difficult to give the pterosaurs too much space, in all honesty. So that is the general idea, because I just really like the idea of having them all here by this big, you know, like lava-filled mountain. I just think that's a pretty cool thing. Look at that, beautiful. Also, this area is really nice, like, to build in general. You can see that over there. I was thinking we were going to build down in this direction, but there's a village over there and stuff gets a little bit iffy, so I'm thinking we're going to move over onto this right-hand side, actually. There's a place down here, which is really nice, and down here where I went a little earlier is really nice as well. So the night is dark and full of terrors. Let's nip upstairs and go to bed. You can see all my teleporting and stuff. Game rule, mob, griefing, blah blah blah, which I had to Google once more. Right, so I have got myself lots of wood. We're going to use the oak wood planks, and we are going to build... Actually, tell you what we're going to do first. So the reason for the dirt is I want to put the pterosaurs down, but I also need a way to... They kind of need to just be up here, because I want to include them in this video, right? But we're not going to be ready for a while. This is probably a 2 or 3 episode project. It's a big project. So the pterosaurs are going to live here. Basically, this is the idea. They're going to live in a little building here. They're going to live in this tiny little hole. I'll tell you what, let's nip back and get a door, just so we can, you know, get them born and spawning, and then we're going to start to build the exhibit around them, essentially. It feels a little bit mean, but I'll get over it there, you know. Fake. Let's just use this priest door, that's fine. Also, that really confused me. I was like, why would I put a feeder in the roof? That's for the Dryosauruses, of course. Right, so... There we go. Let's put our eggs down. hopefully this works. And they're not gonna get out somehow. Right, that's a little pterosaur house. So we are gonna get to work. First of all, we're gonna kill my diving board, unfortunately. And then we're just gonna use some oak planks. We're just gonna stick with the same visual style we've been using all game. So oak planks, and then we're gonna do some spruce around the edge. And a very simple sort of curved wooden platform that kind of ridges out from here. Ridges is probably not the word I want to use there, but we're going for it. Might actually need a little bit more wood, but I did go cut down about 25 trees, so wood should not be a problem. I also found out if you use the axe on, you know how you shift click and it cuts down the entire tree? It's like super helpful. If you use the axe on the leaves and shift click, it kills all the leaves, but it kills your axe in like no time at all. It's moderately annoying. Right, so what I want to do is get the furthest point of this one further out. It's going to be fairly big. And, you know, we need to give them enough room to fly around. We're also going to need to make so much glass. This is probably the biggest project we've done in terms of non-creative mode. Whee! Badonkadonk. Right, so let's have a little look at it from up here. You see, I've built myself a little staircase specifically for this purpose so I can jump up here and check it out. Right, so that's about in the middle, right? So then we want to start curving that around the side of the mountain. God, I love to teleport. I do actually have... So I jumped out again. You should be able to see it. There it is. I did actually build a ladder to get up there in the first place, as you can see. This is like my evidence that I haven't been cheating. I do have a recorded time lapse, but it's just me knocking out a mountain and pausing to text and stuff every now and again. So, well, there's my little... little ladders that I used to get up there in the first place. Right, back to work. So I'm thinking, dangerous. I started thinking, and thinking got me drinking. Sorry. So we just start doing. Oh, okay, right. I came prepared. There we go. Just gonna start knocking this down by one, and we'll just see what it looks like. I haven't really planned this out. Just hoping for something cool. And then down by one again, and then hopefully. It's not going to be even on every side. Well, that's okay. You know how I don't care about symmetry. So you go along by two. And you just put a block just there for no apparent reason. I don't have an axe with me, do I? I use them all. Come on, buddy. There we go. And do one more. And then what we'll do is we'll do it so you don't go two across. You only go one across. So it that should represent a curve. Pretty well. It's fairly easy to make a slight curve. It never looks perfect unless you go and calculate it, but this might be a little bit too small. But remember, we are going to put another block on front of this with the spruce as well. So this would be the plan now, is to start going down more like this, so you only go one block across, if that makes sense. I mean, we can knock a little bit further, and this is the good thing about this. We can kind of... Oh, this is going way further than I want. The mountain is moving! It's okay. I hate this. We can stop it there. And hello, see, we only came around here because I didn't see this cheeky little bit of fossil. All part of the master plan. There we go. We've got some pretty good stuff as well. Nice. Right. Let's go do that on the other side. I might push this out by one more block. One, two, three. So, wait, how many on this side? One, two, three. Over here, one, two, three. Yeah, okay, cool. So again, we just bring it in by one block. And we start moving down. Like so. They call me Blockman. They shouldn't, it's very rude. So one, two, three, four on this side. How many on this side? Oop. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five, six. Let's go check in on our pterosaurs. Okay. Whoops. You can do that. There we go. Is that better, guys? Are we better? Feeling good? Feeling hot, hot, hot. Alright, we're looking good. Leave you alone. So we're probably gonna knock this wall out a bit further this way, because this is pushing out quite a bit further than you want. Ha! Okay, that's a slight problem. We're very close to the... interesting. Oh, my blocks are on fire. Oh. Need to think about this. Tell you what, let's nip down and have a look. Who is even making a shut up world? Wee. I need a little teleport here. Although I do quite like the wee. Africa, it's pretty cool. It doesn't curve enough on that left, on that other side though. So what I think we need to do is tighten up the circle, if that makes sense. Because that left side is longer than the right side. Like, the way that we're looking at it, the left side goes further around than the right-hand side. So, I'm going to go get an axe. Let's go make an axe. Do I have... Let's go some iron. That scared the life out of me! Making that bloody noise. I thought it was a creeper or something. And creepers, in theory, shouldn't be that scary anymore, but they kind of still are. Right, so let's get our... I do actually have a couple fossils knocking around. There you are. Let's get those analysing. And I think I've got some stuff in the sifter as well. Yeah, useless, but still. Shush. Food items. Carrots. That noise. Stop. Desist. Don't need as much dirt as I thought. We'll keep the oak on us just in case. Cool beans. The coolest of beans. Imagine beans that have been like living in the Arctic for like 10 years. I don't really know why. They just went on holiday. They just fell in love. Pembo's going mad over there. Right. Back to the mountain. Right, so we've got an axe. So. How am I doing this? Let me have a little thing. Right, let's kill these. This is slower than I... Oh, also a little dangerous. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I need to bring it in, don't I? Right, we're gonna change it to a 3. So 1, 2, 3. 1. Okay. So then this one comes in. And this one comes in. Like that. Does that make sense? So there's only 2 twos. Does anything I'm saying make sense? I hope so. We just need to knock it in as much as we can. Okay, and then we'll cover that in... Yeah, that'll do, actually. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 2. Okay, cool. 2, 2, and then we just knock these in as well. And then we'll put a little bit of spruce on the front, and we will be looking hunky-dory. Hopefully. That should be even, right? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We might need to knock a couple of those out as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is it just 5? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, okay. Am I making sense? I think I'm making sense. What we're gonna... Ah! Oh. Whoops. Wait, why only 2? Why only 2? Okay, guys, I'm gonna open the door, but you have to stay inside, okay? Hello? My little pterosaur babies! They were trying to kill me by the feels of it. Hello? Okay, guys. Okay, I don't know if they can fly yet. Can they ever fly? I assume they can fly. They're a little bit eager. Right, how am I going to get out without them getting me? Guys. Jesus Christ. You can come out in a bit, okay? Stay there. Okay. Right, this should now be even, I believe. So we're going to cover it with spruce, and this is going to be our platform. Spruce. What's that from? I have no idea. It's from a thing. Is this enough spruce? I feel like this is not enough spruce. We may need to go get more spruce. We're gonna need to go get more spruce. Maybe. It's gonna be tight. Not in a good way. Like, let me think of an appropriate metaphor here. What is a good thing, like, when you, like, you're putting a chair together, right? And you're tightening the bolt and it gets really tight and it can't go any further and you poke it and it doesn't move. That's how tight it is, right? I said not in a good way though, so what's a bad way of being... What's like the worst tight thing? Oh god, don't say that. Answers on a postcard. I might bring this wood down a little bit, like, just so, like, some more of this is oak, if that makes sense. And that'll make the platform bigger, and maybe knock the front of the mountain a bit. It's gonna be cool though, I think. I don't know, we need more spruce. We don't need much more spruce though. Let's nip down. I'm gonna put some torches down on the edge. I need like 3 pieces of spruce, god damn it. Let's jump down and see what it looks like. Like a... Right, you've gone spelunking with your buddies, Bob and Bob 2, right? They're both called Bob. And Bob is a bigger guy. And Bob 2's not. Bob 2 goes through, he goes into this deeper cave, and he has no problems at all. But Bob 2 gets stuck, right? Because it's a little bit tight. And unfortunately, you didn't tell the emergency services where you were, so Bob gets stuck, trapping Bob 2 in the cave. You can't get Bob out, so Bob and Bob 2 both actually die. And you feel quite guilty about it, so you think you're going to go back and talk to the police and talk to the emergency services, but you realise they're both dead. So you don't report it in case you get blamed, and really just leave them there. So there's now 2 corpses living in the middle of the Vietnamese forest that you know are there, but nobody else knows are there. And you tell them they just went off on their own and got lost. Anyways, there it is. Looks pretty good, right? I think the spruce will help. I quite like that. Huh. Let's take a look from the beach house. Don't think I don't see you there, you cheeky son of a bitch. Oh, yeah, that's awesome, actually. That's very cool. Get out of the way. I'm scared about the creeper. Like, it can't even blow anything up, in theory. But it makes me nervous, all the same. Why is it still... But... It's the second creeper! Why is it still blowing things... Oh, I really like that. I think that's awesome. It looks like an evil lair. Okay, now the hard bit is the next bit. A, we need some spruce, and I have actually no idea where the spruce is. I'm gonna go to bed. B, we need to get some sand and some glass. And by some glass, I mean 10 trigillion pieces of glass. I have quite a lot already, but it's not gonna be enough. Where is the spruce? I know there's like a big ass spruce forest. Is that spruce? That's oak. Ah, spruce! The spruce is loose. Right, let's go get some spruce. And then we'll go get some sand. We'll go grab the glass from the... Let's just teleport to the lab. Oh. Blocks, where are you? There we are. Right, so I mean, we've got quite a lot. It seems like a lot, right? It's not enough. It's not even close to enough, I tell you that much. Not even bloody close. Second problem is, how are we going to get in and out of this exhibit? Do we want to? It's going to be filled with pterosaurs, or pteranodons flying around, right? Well, yeah, you know what I mean. Pteranodons, pterosaurs. They're going to be flying around everywhere. We don't want to go inside it, but we do want a good way of viewing it, kind of thing. Also, we should be melting the iron. I know we already have some. Everything is terrible. Oh, wait, this is not the right... There we go. Okay. Spruce! I definitely have mob griefing off, so I'm a little surprised that the creeper is still blowing up the world. I think I really need to go into the config files and turn it off properly. That's... Oh, hello! I've not checked in on the trials. Look at them! Look how big they've gotten! Guys... Dryers are big dinosaurs, way bigger than people think. Also, we need to give them food, because the feeder is not working. I'll sort that out as well. Ah! Did you just bite me? You just bit me, you cheeky son of a bitch! I was not expecting that. Right, if I can land on the fence, we can get over there. Oh, I just got this way, actually. I need to turn this mod back off. I love the baby pigs so much, but the mod is a pain in the ass. It really is. I just need to turn off the automatic breeding, right? And then we can manually breed and set up a farm and stuff down the line. But at the moment, they're just breeding like rabbits. Rabbits on incredible amounts of Viagra. Like, just insane. Hello, little cave. What are you hiding? Fine, then. Keep your secrets. What is that mushroom? Just gonna go murder a spruce. Is this a spruce? No, it's dark. Oh, it's not a spruce. Okay, never mind. Got excited then. Good to know there's a lot of dark. Oh, is this Pig Mountain? Hello, pig. Where's the spruce? Also, what's going on? Oh, okay. What's going on? Why is there a building up here? You were meant to be the chosen piggy. I need to go attach you over here at some point. Is that spruce? That's spruce. Ah, yeah, yeah. Also, what's that? Did I build this? Oh, it's the end of... We've built so much in this series that it's really genuinely becoming difficult to remember what we've done and what we haven't done. I've not been down here in ages. This is where we spawned. Just down there somewhere is where I spawned in for the very first time. People keep asking me about this. I have already showed it, but there's the seed. 3778. And people keep asking me, why is my Minecraft name... Brooker NL. I made this Minecraft account probably 10 years ago, if not more. Like 12 years ago. Whenever the game first came out with accounts, I made this account. You know, it's been a long time since I made this account for the first time. And when I was a youngling, I've been using Photoshop for a very, very long time now. And when I was a kid, I was very active on a forum called GameRenders.com, right? And GameRenders.com was mainly for people who did Photoshop. People discussed games and stuff, but it was mainly for game renders. So people would take wallpapers from video games from GameWallpapers.com, as it happens, and then they would cut down quite a few trees here, and then they would cut out the images, if that makes sense. Like, so if there was a character on the background, they'd cut out the character, because then that character could be used in graphic designs, like standalone on their own. It's kind of like when I'm doing Photoshop for thumbnails, you know, I cut out the dinosaurs and then put them in a different environment so the thumbnail looks better, same kind of thing. So I was very active there, making signatures, which were obviously the, like, that's how most of us got started with Photoshop back in the day, was making signatures for forums and stuff like that. And, you know, I got pretty good at cutting things out as well. A lot of the things I got pretty good at have really helped me with my YouTube thumbnails, as it happens. Anyways, just replant all these. I'm going to make a tree farm as well. Somebody recommend that. Oh my god, I've got so much spruce. Oh my god, where's it all coming from? I'd like to make a tree farm. I really like the idea of a tree farm. I don't really know why. I'm going to plant some of these, because I like it when they're in the environment. It looks nicer. Should put them on the edge, though. We'll keep hold of the others. I don't want 13. 13 is a stupid number. I want 12. I got that there. Okay, so let's go back. Terracell Mountain. Turn the spruce into blocks. Don't need all that right now, but we will eventually. Okay, just. Nope, wrong side. Anyways, so I was on Game Renders. And, well, basically. I was in a graphics crew, I guess is like the only way to do. Did I put the oak away? God damn it. I was in a crew, and what we did was like we had a little crew. We had a group of like 5 or 6 of us who were probably like the best people on the server, if I'm honest. I was pretty talented back in the day. And we would make signatures for people in exchange for reputation points and stuff like that. You know, we traded our skills for goods, essentially. I'm just gonna add a little bit more wood. Just a little bit. Anyways, our crew was my name on the Game Renders forum was Broken, because I was an emo little kid when this first started. I mean, I was literally, I don't know, 12 years old when I first did this, if not. Yeah, probably about 12, 13, 14, something like that. I don't know. Low teens when I first started doing this stuff. So I called myself Broken because I was an NG kid, teenager. And the crew I joined was called Next Level. So this is a very long story for it. It's a very simple answer really, but I'm just killing time. The crew I joined was called Next Level, so I changed my forum name to Broker NL. So the N from Broken became the N from NL, so Broker NL. And then it just kind of became a thing that I just kept for a few years after that, basically, and every time I made an account, that was my username. Could have probably said that a lot easier. I wanted to give you some vibrant backstory, okay? Right, glass time. Don't know how much we're going to get done here, but we're going to try. So all we're going to do is follow the shape of the... I like the idea of there being a little lip, so we're going to use the spruce. We're definitely going to need to add more wood, probably in the straight line across from there. Yeah, I like the idea of a little lip, so we're just going to do like this, all the way along. Now, I don't think we're going to be letting the pteranodons out today, but maybe by the end of the next video, we can let them do their thing. what I'm thinking as well, actually. Do I have any cobblestone? Yes, just a little bit. I'm just going to bring that up. I think that looks better. And we go back again. I'm sure there's a quicker way to do this. There is an item called it's like a wand item, which has a creative version and a non-creative version. I don't know if it does the same thing. Probably does. Actually, I'll search for it. Wand? Builder's wand. Magical... Okay, I have no idea how to get any of this. Cold ingot, we can get magical wood. Oh, that's not so bad, right? We can make a bookshelf. So what that'll do is, you'd target this with the wand, and it would just add an extra layer of glass on top of it, but it would use the glass in your inventory, basically. It's just much quicker. I'm going to look into that and into Tinkers, and we'll try to up our building resource collection game a little bit. Okay, so the idea is for this to go up. I shouldn't have come down. It's for it to go up quite a bit and then curve into like a bubble that kind of curves back inside the mountain. It's not going to be that much room to fly in, really. I mean, we'll probably knock out the front of the mountain a bit. So that's why I'm thinking we need to do like a chasm in the middle, or just like proper open this inside area out completely, go all the way up, like hollow out the inside of the mountain. And that'll be like a little secret place that you can't see from the outside. It's also going to take about 10 billion years. Alright. But whatever. It's worth it for my beloved Pteranodons. We've been working on this Pteranodon idea for a long time about where they were going to go. And I do appreciate all the suggestions and the names and stuff like that. I just couldn't use them all, and I wanted to use the lava mountain for something. And I think a lot of people wanted to see us use a mountain. It makes sense. You know, Pteranodon, it's going to live in a mountainous environment. Oh, well, not necessarily. But it's going to spend a lot of time on rock, you know? And you can see them living in a mountain. Well, you will be able to anyway. Okay, we're going to take a little peek downstairs and see what this looks like. Geronimo! One day I'll jump too far and be very dead, basically. You ready? Oh, sorry. Boom! I really like this. I think this is awesome. I'd like to put some lights underneath it, and then maybe a ladder up into the exhibit. Like, we'll carve straight down and have a ladder going all the way up into the exhibit, because you're going to want to go in for feeding purposes. When we do the monorail, our next big creative project at 50 level, episode 50, we're going to do a monorail attaching the whole park, and we'll have it. Anyway, it's not going to be a monorail, it's going to be a train track. But it's going to be on stilts, it's going to be like going all around, it's going to be cool. And we'll have that going over here, I think, as well. So, yeah, it's cool. Also going to put in some pillars, probably here and here, just so it looks more like the wood. Actually, we can do that right now. Just like this. Just so it looks a little bit more like it's being supported by just something, you know? Doesn't really matter. I mean, we can neaten that up at some point, but yeah, I mean, that makes a lot of sense. Right, let's go back up. Let's make a little staircase. Now, I don't know... This really isn't enough room for a Pteranodon, is it? We might actually finish this. No, we're out of glass. I'm thinking we're going to go up one more, and then we're going to bring it in by one. Let's just try to get one more line done, if possible. It's going to be a little iffy. I mean, I don't think they can fly yet, but I'm worried that if I let them out, then by the time we get back to fixing, or by next episode when we come to finish this off, they'll be able to fly by then, and just fly out. They'll just do one, and I'll be gone. And I'll be sad. So I think we have to keep them contained just a little bit longer. Okay, guys? I'm sorry. Oh, they're sleeping! Adorable. Right, I'll go to bed. Nope, nope. Back in. Back in you go. Come on. Damn it. Come here. In. There we go. Alright. You know what we need to do? Okay, I've got a plan. Got a plan. There's a lot of enemies over there. Just gonna grab a little bit of glass. Oh, go away! Not here for you. Got things to do, son. Go away. Lab. Lab. Okay, cool. I think I can hear the Triceratops above. That's pretty cool. Right, so. I am really running out of room. We did not need all of this stuff, to say the least. Is there anything there I can get rid of? We don't need all this cobblestone. That's an insane amount of cobblestone. Nobody in history has ever needed that much cobblestone, so let's put that away. Get out the glass we already have, which is more than I thought, admittedly. Get that sand cooking, I guess, sort of. Materials goes in there. Spruce goes in here. Gravel goes in here. So there's a bit of dirt in here. Nice. Yeah, okay. Oh, chisel. Do we have a chisel? How do we make a chisel? How do we make a chisel? Tell me, game. Talk to me. Is that one right? Yep. No, okay. Literally the easiest thing in the world when you have this much iron. Let's just make two of those. Have I done this wrong already? No, okay. Like, easiest thing in the world. Instantly screws it up. Okay. So, we're gonna nip back to the mountain, and whilst they're asleep, a little bit of a waste of glass, but now at least we can check on them. And let's put a little dirt platform here as well, so we can hop over and tell you what. This is why I use dirt, by the way. So I could actually, there we go, look at that little pteranodon. It's a little, oh, we should have put them in the, no, I was going to say we should have put them, why do I only see two? So we should have, get it inside. Should have put them in the hatching pen, but that would be a terrible, terrible idea, so never mind. Right, let's go use up the rest of our pork chop. I love that noise. That footstep noise and glass is really satisfying, actually. I think we keep going. I was going to say, I'm going to stop bringing it in now, but it's going to come in really quickly. Like, the idea is we just go one block in until we hit the wall, right? That's going to happen in, like, four or five. It's not going to take long at all. So I'm thinking we go up by another two. Maybe that's madness. You know me. So it's less a dome and more a wall with a curvy bit on top, basically. This at least gives them a bit of room. Like I said, we'll knock that in probably a little bit. What is... Why is... What? Who are you? I want to go meet that man. Let's go say hi. Inadvertently built a staircase here. Is it a werewolf? Is it just a random ass villager for some reason? Hello? Animal, okay, do you want to come? Come here. Sorry. You okay? Yeah, you're fine. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Now, you live with my pteranodons now. You are now my zookeeper for my pteranodons, eh? That's pretty cool. right, yeah, so that's going to come up until there. We'll knock this in, and we'll just, I think if we hollow this out, it's kind of like a turtle shell, right? If you imagine, it's kind of like a turtle. If you imagine this is the turtle's head, curves into the shell, which is the mountain, but the inside the mountain is where the actual body, where they'll fly around us. Does that make sense? Everyone having a good time? Everyone's in there sleeping around? Let's go to bed. Okay, so the plan is to finish this off next episode. I will acquire much more glass, basically, and I'll probably start working on the hollowing out process, because that's going to take a bajillion years, and I am doing it all manually because I'm a madman. I could just cheat and lie, but I'm determined to do this in survival, except for our sort of grander projects. So anyways, no, the good thing about this as well is you guys can leave some comments down below. You know, what do you think? What's working? What's not working? Should we change things up? Let me know within the realms of possibility, given I am playing on survival mode. But I think Turtle Mountain is a good idea. how we're going to get up here, I don't know. But I'd like to then start building, like, on there and to use this bit of the water. Maybe we can do another water exhibit in this bit. And then start building over there. And just kind of use this area. Oh, that was really nice over there as well. Just use this area a little bit more. And then I really want to do the monorail. I really want to get everything connected together because I think it's going to be really cool. Also going to take a billion years even in creative. Anyways. How are we doing, buddy? Can you just come over here for the sake of my thumbnail? I need you to look into the light. That'll do. Cheers. Sorry. Oh god, I'm dying. It out. Oh. Bless them. Why are they... It looks like they're trying to attack me, but they're too small to do any damage. I can't get a good thumbnail if you're this close. No. Okay, crazy bloody things. Right. Well, here we go, folks. Pteranodon Mountain. Thank you for joining me. If you did like this video, please do hit the like button. I know we're a little slow on Minecraft. It's one episode a week at the moment. There is quite a lot of work that goes into a video. I'm going to try to push it to two going forward. Today's Friday, so there's not going to be a second episode this week. Next week, I will try to do two episodes a week going forward. It might not always be the case, but I know it's a little bit too much of a wait, and people do get a little bit angsty. Okay. People do get a little angsty about it, and that's totally fair enough, so... What did I just see? Right, so yeah, thank you for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way. I'll see you next time.